Now, a poet finds the words to tell her own story of grief. Jeffrey Brown has our conversation fresh off the NewsHour bookshelf.
The story seems to begin with catastrophe, but in fact began earlier, and is not a tragedy, but rather a love story. Those are the first lines of a new memoir by poet Elizabeth Alexander, titled The Light of the World. The catastrophe occurred in 2012, the sudden death of her husband, Fikre Ghebreyesus, of a heart attack, just days after his 50th surprise birthday party.
There's just the strangeness of absence.
It's just so unnatural that he's not coming to dinner.
Unnatural, and also, you know, someone's things are around, someone's smell is around, someone's garden is coming up that he planted, finding a book and seeing the page marked where he was reading. All of that trace was what I found. You know, it takes a while, even though, of course, you know, sadly, you know that they're not coming back.
The love story is the one they shared for 16 years, raising two young boys, Solomon and Simon, now 17 and 15.
A happy marriage is hard won. So, you know, we worked to make our marriage and our family. But did I feel awash with fortune, even as we struggled through the struggles of the day? Absolutely.
Praise song for the day.
Elizabeth Alexander came into the national spotlight in 2009 when she read her poem Praise Song for the Day at Barack Obama's first inauguration.
All about us is noise and bramble, thorn and din.
She's the author of 6 books of poetry, one of them American Sublime, a finalist for the Pulitzer Prize. And she's a professor of African American Studies at Yale University. It was in New Haven that she met Fikre, an immigrant from Eritrea who had fled war.
One of the things that gives the story such resonance is such an American story, right? Black woman coming, a descendant from slave families, immigrant man, right? Escaping war, starting his life anew.
Well, I'm so happy that you see it that way because I wasn't aware of it in the writing, but it's absolutely true. The Americanness of it, the Americanness of, you know, immigrants at what stage in the American story. And also, many American marriages are mixed in some way that you wouldn't expect. Mm-hmm. You know, not just straightforward religious mixing or, you know, black person and white person coming together, but mixing cultures with some kind of baseline of understanding that draws you to the person who is your partner.
In addition to his family, Fikre had 2 great passions. There was cooking. He was a chef and had a restaurant in New Haven.
This is an early watercolor. Mm-hmm.
And then there was his painting.
And then this painting, which I love, which I see every day when I open my eyes, is called Visitation. And it's an allegory of our first meeting in Fikre's studio in New Haven.
The walls of Alexander's apartment, she moved into Manhattan last year,
yes,
are filled with his work.
I was very surprised that I started writing almost immediately after Fikre died. I didn't think that it was anything that was going to become a poem or become a memoir. I just knew that I was keeping track of things in some kind of way. Not even looking at what I did, not even thinking much about it, but just doing it.
Keeping track of what? Your feelings?
I wouldn't even call them feelings. I would call them perceptions and living and surviving. Writing was actually my feet on the earth. It felt like that was how I knew that I was anchored to something and that I needed to track what I was moving through, even though I wouldn't say it was cathartic or it helped me move through my grief. It wasn't like that. It was actually, now that I look back on it, more profoundly about processing the world through art and writing.
There's a line where you say, how much space for remembering is there in a day? That struck me because of much of the book is sort of remembering little things.
Yes.
Even a recipe of his.
I feel that it's a book of prose that's a poet's prose because it came
A
poet's prose,
yeah.
In that I felt that it came from the same visceral place that poetry comes from. It came word first and word by word, and always with attention to music. The chapters are, they're not prose poems, but they're short, they're condensed. Mm-hmm. They have the economy of poetry because that's kind of how I'm wired. I knew I could not undo what had happened. I knew I couldn't really fix anything in time, but I think that in writing, we do try to fix moments so that somehow they're captured. And that's, I just wanted to be very careful. I wanted to be precise and precisely ask myself what I saw and felt and knew and remembered.
You must have now become part of a conversation of grief in a sense. Do you tell people that you learned something, or is this an offering of learning?
Grief is so singular, even as it is our universal. We've all been through it, or we will all come to it. That is the truth. So I wouldn't presume to say I did it this way, so you should do it this way, or anything like that. Every family, every person, we all know our griefs and our challenges. They just come at different times in different ways. So he and I had each known them in different ways at different points. His loss was the biggest one, the most consequential one. Mm-hmm. But in that, honestly, was the blessing of having known him. No one is guaranteed love. No one is guaranteed children. No one is guaranteed the synchronicity that we had. Mm-hmm. So I was very aware always that that was something that was indelible.
The book is The Light of the World, Elizabeth Alexander. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for the conversation.